Welcome to the second video in the educational series titled How to Present a Paper in a Conference, designed by Manipal Association of Pharmacy Students in collaboration with Center for Digital Learning MCOPS. I am Keerthi Priya at the Department of Pharmacology. In the last video, we have given our recommendations on how to select an appropriate conference to present your paper. In this video, let's discuss how to prepare an abstract. The general structure of an abstract contains title of the paper, list of authors, author affiliation, details of the presenting author, body of the abstract, followed by keywords. Let us discuss these elements one by one. The title has to be appropriate, concise, and it should give a gist of your work. Since information retrieval systems use titles to display results, it should reflect the work done in your paper. Avoid using formulae and non-standard abbreviations. An ideal title usually reveals three things: what you have done, which is usually the aim of your work; how you have done, giving some hint about the methodology; and what result was obtained. Generally, the abstract guidelines do not mention any word limit for the title, but it is better to limit the number of words to less than 25. Let us now look at a few examples of titles. Evaluation of antioxidant activities of osimum serpentum. This does not seem an appropriate one. Let us review this title now. Does it mention what was done? Yes. Does it say how it was done? No. Does it say what were the results? No. Also, what part of the plant was used for the study? Is it the whole plant or just the leaves or only the roots? Not mentioned. What extract was exactly used for testing? An aqueous extract or some organic solvent extract? Again, no information is provided. You see, here the title reveals very little about the actual work done. It sounds like the objective of somebody's project work, but it is not fit to be the title of a research paper. Let us see how we can modify this title. How about evaluation of antioxidant activities of ethanolic leaf extract of osimum serpentum? This sounds better, right? No. It can further be modified. Evaluation of antioxidant activities of ethanolic leaf extract of osimum serpentum using DPPH and ABTS assays. Now we know what was done and how it was done, but it still does not say anything about the result. So how about this? Ethanolic leaf extract of osimum serpentum exhibits antioxidant activity in DPPH and ABTS assays. Perfect. All the information needed is available in this title, that is the aim, the methodology and the result. Many times it is not possible to mention the result in the title. For example, ethanolic leaf extract of osimum serpentum shows no antioxidant activity in DPPH and APTS assays. Does not sound interesting and attractive even though it is scientifically relevant. This is because of the negative results obtained. But papers with negative results are equally important as the ones with positive results. So in such cases, you may use the format such as evaluation of antioxidant activities of ethanolic leaf extract of osimum serpentum using DPPH and ABTS assays. Here, the result is not mentioned, but that's okay. Also, in many branches of science and arts, it may not be possible to prepare a title that reflects the results in it. In such cases, you may design the title that reflects the what and how of the research. Here is an example. On some properties of regular matrices over a commutative ring. It may be difficult to include the methodology and results in this title. You may even prepare a catchy or a witty title to draw attention to your work without compromising on the scientific aspect of it. Next, authors. All those people who significantly contributed to the research work should be credited as authors. Contribution to the research includes conceptualization or designing of the study, conduct of study, data analysis, preparation of manuscript, etc. Credit should be given to all those who have significantly contributed to the work. While listing the author's names, prefixes like Dr., Professor, Mr., Miss, Mrs. should not be used. Full name of the authors, that is, first name followed by last name, should be written. Upon completion of a research project, when a manuscript is prepared for publication, the contributing authors may be classified as first author, co-authors, and corresponding author. A first author is the one who has contributed the most for the work, and his name appears first in the author's list. This is usually a student, research scholar, or junior faculty whose research topic has culminated in the form of a manuscript. A co-author is the one who has helped the first author in the work, and there can be more than one co-author in a paper. A corresponding author is generally the person who has conceptualized and supervised the work and is usually the guide or mentor of the first author. So, in a publication, the sequence of authors is first author, followed by co-authors, and ending with the corresponding author. Only the proposed corresponding author or the first author can present a particular work at any conference, because they are the ones who either conceptualized the project or contributed the most towards it. However, co-authors may also present the work if the corresponding author has no objection. Now, coming to the list of the authors in a conference presentation, that is, for abstract and while poster or oral presentation, the authors are designated as a presenting author and co-authors. Please note that conferences do not categorize or designate authors into first and corresponding authors. A presenting author is the one who is presenting the work at a conference. In an abstract being submitted for a conference presentation, placing the presenting author's name among the list of the authors varies from conference to conference. For this, read the abstract guidelines carefully. Most of the conferences allow retaining the actual order of authors, and the presenting author's name is asked to be indicated by underlining or marking with an asterisk. So, check author guidelines to know how to indicate the presenting author. Sometimes the presenting author's name is asked to be placed first. So, in case one of the co-authors is a presenting author on behalf of all the authors, his name will have to be listed first. So, the presenting author becomes the first author for conference presentation. This is for mere convenience purpose only and has nothing to do with the actual order of authors based on their contribution to the project. Usually, there is no restriction on the number of authors included for presentation. But some organizers put a cap on this number. In such cases, the decision on list of names should be taken in consultation with the first author and the corresponding author of the work. Author's affiliations. Each author's name is followed by a lowercase superscript letter or a superscript number as per the abstract guidelines to indicate their respective affiliation. The same superscript is used in front of the affiliation. In the affiliation, write the name of the department, institute, and full postal address. While writing the first and co-authors' affiliations, do not mention the designation of the authors, their phone numbers, or their email IDs. This information has to be given only for the presenting author. Presenting author's name has to be indicated clearly. Presenting author's telephone number along with the country code, email ID, and complete postal address have to be provided. The following animation shows how the author's name and affiliations are to be written. Let us now see how the body of the abstract is constructed. Here are a few points to remember while preparing an abstract. Abstracts have word limits, usually between 200 to 300. Read the abstract guidelines carefully to know the word limit. An abstract should not contain flowcharts, tables or diagrams. Non-standard or uncommon abbreviations should be avoided. If it is really necessary, they must be indicated in their first mention. Font style and size will be mentioned in the guidelines and should remain constant throughout the abstract. If the information is not provided on this, use the font Times New Roman with font size 12 and a line spacing of 1. Abstracts can be of two types, structured and unstructured. A structured abstract usually contains four sections: background, methods, results, and conclusion. In the background section, briefly explain background of the study or the need for the study, research gap identified, research questions formulated or aims and objectives, and novelty of the study in the scientific context. Under methods, describe the materials used for the study like chemicals, instruments, software, etc. If living organisms are used, mention their details and the tests conducted. Give details of permissions obtained from regulatory bodies if applicable. And give a brief outline of the procedures of the experiments carried out. In results, explain the major results obtained from each of the experiments, which may include qualitative features and quantitative values. Under conclusion, discuss briefly what can be inferred from the results and their interpretations, key findings of the work, shortcomings of the study, future scope or recommendations, and the final conclusion. Here is a template of the structured abstract. The content of an unstructured abstract is exactly same as that of the structured one, except that the contents are not subdivided into separate sections. Here is a format of an unstructured abstract. The guidelines will specify which type of abstract is to be submitted. However, if it is not mentioned, you may prepare a structured abstract. The last section of the abstract is keywords. Keywords are useful for indexing purposes. Therefore, only those keywords that reflect the specific research work should be written. 3 to 5 keywords relevant to the study must be given. Avoid very general and non-specific terms. Do not use words like of, in, the, etc. If abbreviations are added, use only well-established abbreviations. Here is an example of choosing the keywords for the title we have used earlier. Ethanolic leaf extract of Osimum serpentum exhibits antioxidant activity in DPPH and ABTS assays. For this, keywords like Osimum serpentum, antioxidant activity, DPPH assay, ABTS assay are good ones. But keywords like ethanolic extract, herbal product, natural product, etc. are inappropriate. Finally, preparing an abstract with all the required elements, satisfying the conference guidelines and keeping it within the word limit is a challenging task. But it is fun and can be mastered with practice. Hope this lecture was useful. If you have any queries or comments, mail us at i2c.mcorps@gmail.com or post below in the comment section. Thank you.